Welcome back, everyone, to Open Line. Talking about the legislative session that just happened. It was on education. We have with us Representative Mark White. He's a Republican from Memphis, chairman of the Education Committee in the House. Talking a lot about virtual versus in-person learning and tying state funding to that and kind of when students in Memphis and Nashville will be back in the classroom. Just thoughts on that. Take another call, and then we're going to talk about pay raises for teachers. Let's go to Tony. Hello, Tony.
Yeah, how you doing? Thank you for taking my call. My number one complaint is I have sons, daughters, nieces, nephews working for these schools, districts in Tennessee, especially Nashville, Tennessee. Some are custodians, some are campus security. And you don't ever say nothing about them getting this shot. They working around all these teachers, all these diseases. Teachers are still coming to school working. I'm not really no union person like I used to be, but those teachers could work at home. I see here in Nashville, they're digging up the sidewalks on these cable lines or AT&T. These social services people don't have no money, and these social services of metro government, like I used to do, they don't have no money. They're giving all the money to the teachers. Now, a lot of these parents, I have to say this, they are Republican, and they refuse to wear the mask. The parents, you know, the kids gonna do exactly what the parents do, and you wanna send these kids back to school when they don't even wanna wear the mask at home, in grocery store, while I've been shopping, Walmart, and whatever, and you wanna send them to school, what you gonna do if they don't wanna wear the mask? Send them back home? Now, when I was working with metro schools, the grandparents raised the kids, and that's 15 years ago. You couldn't get a hold of the parents. If something happened, you had to call the grandparents. And these parents is not working. They're at home. If they don't want to have no education to train these kids, that's their fault. They just want a babysitter. They ain't going to get it. If you're getting government aid every month, food stamps and everything, you got to be able to take care of them kids. And my children are going to devilish. I have to go to clinics every other month to get these vaccinations and these shots and get treatment because these parents are lazy and lackadaisical and want to be like Trump, don't want to wear
the mask. So what is your bottom line? What are you saying? They should go back in or they shouldn't go back in?
I think they just need to wait and just get them trained up and just go back early next year because they ain't gonna get ahead if they go back now anyway. They still behind the eight ball. So if they can do it. When I went to school, I had to go to special reading classes. They picked us out of class every day to send us in there, and I came out ahead.
Okay.
Because
all
special
right.
reading classes helped me.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you. That's Tony. All right. We're several calls from, it sounds like people saying just wait. But here in Nashville, they're saying, of course, go back in the fall. And what you said at the top here is in Memphis, where you are, they're saying we may not do that, and we may not revisit this until Thanksgiving of next year. So you hear Tony, he's saying just wait, go back in the fall. I guess what do you think about what he's saying there?
Yeah, and I hear what Tony's saying, and so you know it would probably be very, very difficult. I hope that the administrations in Nashville will work on a plan to help the rest of the school year for those parents who want to come back in, and I understand the challenges, and also Shelby County and Memphis is the same thing. But it will be very difficult at this point, you know, we're approaching February, to turn on a dime and maybe get them back in. But I would love to see the younger grades go back at least. And you know, another thing that we need to consider, and there again, we take the virus very seriously, but some of the best years of our life was high school, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade, and these children are missing that right now, these high school juniors and seniors. That really breaks my heart.
Let's talk about teacher pay raises. There was a pay raise that was passed, I believe it's 2%, but that's going to translate to even less than 2% in some districts. Some teachers have said that's kind of a slap in the face, they should get a pay raise, but that's a very low pay raise. Where do we stand with teacher pay right now?
Okay, and just to and this is a difficult conversation because the numbers are always moving. I've been in the General Assembly now, this is going on the 12th year. Over the last 8 years, we put $1.5 billion new dollars into our public education in Tennessee. We're now up about $6.8 billion. During that time, we've also put $550 million approximately into additional pay raises and or benefits for teachers. So another half a billion dollars there. Here's the problem. We've kind of learned our lesson in the General Assembly. You never say 2%, 4%, or whatever percent, because we give a lot of flexibility to our ELAs once the money goes to them on how they distribute that. Money from the state comes through a BEP formula, the basic education plan, and it's a funding formula. And so when you send money to them, it funds a set amount of teachers for so many students. But most districts, because we've mandated a lot too, and we've done it to ourselves, but if a certain school district, the BEP, say, pays for 100 teachers, they may have hired additional 20 teachers to do various things or to double up, and or you may want a physics teacher or a chemistry teacher that's hard to find, and you had to pay that person a bit more. So then we send down 4%, and pretty soon it's diluted to about 2% or 1% for the teachers, because the LAs have the discretion. So this year, we're not going to say 2% or 4%. We've got $42 million that we're putting in the budget passed last week, and we're asking our LAs, give this money to the teachers. Don't spread out anywhere else. Give this money to the teachers. And I think we're going to look at another tranche of money when we go back in the special session in February, March, and April. But that's what happens. You know, we can save 4%, but when the LEAs have the option to kind of spend it the way they want to, which is, you know, local control, we get that. But General Assembly, we've learned our lesson. We will quit saying 2 or 4 or 5% because it doesn't happen that way.
Yet I saw it reported this was 2%. So you're saying this wasn't 2% that was passed in this special session. It was just 43 million.
Right, 43 million. And also, to make people comfortable, a lot of times when you send down more money to the state, it puts a burden on the counties to maintenance of effort. We're also matching the local portion so that the counties don't have to worry about putting any money in, so they won't have to be hit with property tax or anything. The state's coming up with all the money for this.
We've heard teachers say for a long time, teacher pay in Tennessee is low. Do you think you'll come up with more than $43 million? Do you expect more money? And how much more might be reasonable to expect in this next session?
Yeah, I don't know how much more. I'm expecting I think the governor wants to put more. We understand that we need to continue to put more money into our teacher pay. We had $650 million in the budget before the COVID hit last in 2020, which we lost all that due to the COVID, and pulled back $1 billion. The good news is state revenue is not down. We are about $775 million above this time last year. So revenue's still been coming in. We haven't been hit. Where it went down, you know, our restaurants and our hotels got hit pretty hard, and I'm anxious for them to come back. But it went up in other areas. Boat sales, RVs, camping equipment just went through the roof this past year. So where it went down in one area, it came up in another. So our revenue is good. So that's good news. So we will have the money from the state, hopefully, to look at additional opportunities for our teachers.
All right, we'll take a break, come back, and I want to talk about testing and what was decided. We'll take a break, be back right after this.